Hey guys, it's Dom here. I want to show you the Numa Nero that showed up. I was on the Sounds Online forum and people had talked about the Numa product. The White, the Nano, the Nero. Nobody else actually had the piano. So what I did was I went out and bought the Numa Nero. I thought that maybe I could do a little video blog here showing you the features, what the piano looks like, the action, and actually give you a true judgment on what the piano is like and how it feels. Lots of people like the Yamaha, a lot of people like the Cruisewell. I mean, for me, I've used everything from a Yamaha Motif to a Cork Triton, doing hip-hop production, to MPC drum pads. You're looking to an upright acoustic piano, to the Axiom Pro. So I mean, I've had a good judge of different key weights and feels and what I like and what I don't like. So now I'm about to try the Numa Nero, which supposedly closest action you'll find towards a real concert feel piano. So it has the wood keys, it has gradient action from low to high, so a little bit harder to push the low keys, a lot lighter on the high end, solid black keys. So you're really going to find a lot of characteristics of a real piano keyboard into the Numa Nero. So here, let me show you what we're looking at here.
And then I'll take his bags of toys and run, and bring to all the kids who don't have none.
Okay, something I want to show you here is the bottom of the Nero. Pretty rugged, pretty solid. I mean, it weighs a ton. It's probably one of the more durable pieces I've actually picked up. So I'm gonna flip that over and throw it up on my desk. I'm back
okay,
in a sec.
So
inside that little box that we looked at, you are going to see all different connections depending on the power source that you're connecting to. And the foot pedal. The foot pedal is single for one input, just for sustain. We also have the music holder, which will go, when you open this up, you will find the stand holder right there. I haven't put it up yet, it's just sitting behind me. But overall, this thing's pretty sweet. It's got a nice black piano finish all the way through. And there's all your connections. One to the side. The mod wheel. And then the aluminum top. So to get the aluminum top open, it takes two hands here, but you just slide that back. Kind of running out of room on the desk, but pull that back a bit. Locks there, locks there. And now you have a stand to put your mouse onto, or your music holder fits into right in there. So you have all your controls right there. Everything seems to be touch control here. Got the plastic still on there. Take that off when I'm ready. But quite nice, actually. The keys are probably, for the price that I paid for this compared to some of the higher end piano controllers, you're looking at the Rolands or something. These are very nice. These are probably everything that everybody said. If they said that the piano action is nice, believe them. The gradient. Very nice all the way through. No complaints whatsoever. Feels amazing, actually. This is one of the best piano controls I've ever played on, even felt. And I've gone through quite a few when I was in the music store, though nobody had this one. This was custom order, so I kind of went on a whim. But as you can see, it is nice, and it plays nice, it feels nice, and it's durable. The only complaint I have right now is it is a little tall. Here, sit down here a little bit. It is a little tall. It's, I think, almost 5 inches tall at the back. And that's the only downside I can see. I do need to raise my monitors up a little bit. But those computer monitors are being sold. Those are the dual 30-inch Apple Cinema displays. They are being sold, and they are switching for 3 24-inch cinema displays with the LED backlit. So when that happens, I'll raise all the monitors up a little bit, and I'll have a little bit more room to slide the piano underneath the monitors to give me a little bit more desk space. Yeah, really, everything that you've read on the forums, and the positive side has really been, it's true, it's all here. Some people would like to have more than one pedal. I mean, most real true feel pianos will have 3 pedals. I'm not even sure if you can or not, but I can't see why you wouldn't be able to buy a 3 pedal setup in a stereo setup with some sort of connections and an outboard DI box or something that you could run your cables into. Other than that, that's everything I would need, and more, actually. As you can see, my setup is fairly simple. I had a rack of pianos over here. Right now I have the Cork Triton sitting up on a stand getting ready to go. I have somebody coming by to purchase that. And there's my rack, my Digio 3. Right behind that wall here is the Rolex panels. We're going to be, in the new year, cutting a hole in that wall and building almost like a machine cabinet to put all the rack gear and the computers. A couple Mac Pros that are going to go in there. And we'll basically keep everything off the floor and into that cabinet so it's nice and quiet. Eventually going to get a better setup here for the piano. Looking for a new desk. So if any of you have any ideas on a desk that would be perfect to keep this mounted underneath, something quality. I mean, I don't want to buy crap. So let me know. And if you have any questions about the piano, give me a shout and I'll try and answer them the best that I can. Alright, hope you enjoyed. You can email me at info@logicalproductions.ca or find me on YouTube at youtube.com/MacUserLogic. So there it is, the Numa Nero. Decided to throw it up on my stand instead. Get it off the desk. It's a Triton and the Axiom Pro 49. Very simple, looks way better on the stand. So it'll stay there for now,
and then when we open up the wall, we're going to have to move everything again, but hopefully you guys can have some good suggestions. We've already started some of the renovations, as you can see, building up the tile, redoing the fireplace. All that's getting redone, the lighting's been redone, we've got to rehang some of the wires, and making sure that everything's ready to build. So, anyways, take care, just thought I'd show you that, and look forward to my other videos. Alright, peace.